Our federation and its national association defend the right of life without compromise. We are representative of road traffic victims and victim families. We are already an unavoidable pressure group influencing international road safety policy. And even if we have limited financial resources, we have a strong moral support among large sectors of public opinion, as well as among European and world international organizations. Thank you very much.
Today, on 29th October, the day which would have been Marcel's 90th birthday, I want to thank him for his wisdom in founding Fèvre after the death of his daughter. The Federation represents a pioneering road victim movement which has given passionate but small and poorly resourced national road victim associations greater influence and a much stronger voice with governments in their own countries and high-level global organizations, largely due to the Federation's UN consultative status. This was achieved for Fèvre by Marcel, who was a professor of nuclear physics and scientific advisor to the European Commission. It enabled Fèvre to advocate on behalf of road victims at WHO and UN meetings and working parties. It made possible the adoption by the UN of our World Day of Remembrance in 2005. It enabled our input into the Decade of Action Plan, launched only yesterday, ensuring that investigation and justice are included as post-crash actions. I was privileged to work closely with Marcel for 11 years, since 1993, and to continue after his death in 2004 as Fèvre's second president. Happy birthday, Marcel.
Unfortunately, due to the pandemic, we could not celebrate our 30th anniversary this year, as we did it for the Silver Jubileum just 5 years ago in Brussels. Nevertheless, we wanted to share some of the main activities from the last 3 decades and dedicate these to Marcel Hegi. And I'm sure that Marcel would have appreciated all what we have achieved, and I wish Fèvre all the best for the next 30 years.